I'm very happy to see you all in such a beautiful dresses, Dusradekas, and also in a good mood to get married. You must keep up your attitude, all right? You should be happy people and try to keep your husbands also happy. Your happiness can create happiness for the children. Now, one thing I want to warn you, not to tell your husband about anything which was wrong in your past life. That's not to be done. There's no need, because you are now Sahajogis. You are changed people, and whatever has happened, has happened. You need not talk about it or tell him anything about it, but talk of the future and the present, all right? So be sensible. It's your sensibility which is going to make a happy married life. If you become insensible, if there's no wisdom, then marriages will fail. Some girls I've seen dominate their husbands too much. There is no need to dominate. If you love the husband, that's how the domination is. Is the best way is to love your husband, look after him, do whatever is needed. Because no, he is showing off that you are from a better society or a better culture or a better family background. It's only you who can show that you are really a good person, and your goodness will win him over. So it's only the wife who makes or spoils the marriage. And I have to tell you very frankly that if you still have some doubts about your marriage, or if you are still thinking this was not a good match, you should withdraw now. And later on you should not go on finding faults with your husband. You see, men are men and women are women. Men cannot be women. But you can make them understand that women are to be respected. All right? And how? That you will have to see by your behavior. If your behavior is good, they'll respect you. But if your behavior is childish, or if your behavior is aggressive, no man can appreciate a woman who is aggressive. And so you should not be aggressive. Whatever he says, you should agree and listen to him. Fundamental things, of course, is there, but otherwise, for small things, you should not try to dominate your husband. It's not a sign of Sahajogini. Sahajogini has to, with love and understanding and wisdom, has to win over the husband, and not by domination. This is one thing we should understand, that many marriages are broken because of domination. Second thing is, you are naturally attached to your parents, attached to your family, attached to your country. But now, forget it. Be attached to your husband's family, husband, and things around. Because if you are attached to your family, you still spoil the relationship. I have known many couples being broken because of this. There was a girl who was very much worried about her father because he lost the business. And she made the whole life miserable. So the husband disappeared. And he wanted to do something else. And she was left in the lurch, and she had to go to her father. And then she realized how difficult it is to live in father's house. So it's your house, it's your home, it's your husband. All right, you don't have to sort of go on searching another person or another woman who will help you. It's you who can help yourself, all right? Because now we have very bad experiences of some girls who have left their husband and come away to their families with the children. Is the family going to look after them all their lives? Who is going to look after them? So use your brains and don't try to show off that you are something superior, or something higher, or you something more. say something, you should be humble. The humble you are, the better it is. Otherwise, arrogance doesn't be a woman. She doesn't look nice. She looks like a horse sometimes. And looks like, I don't know, like what. So it is better to be humble and to be kind and to be nice and to prove that you are a good-natured person. All right.